Tonight, these are just some of the faces of a problem inside the Pardon and Parole Board. Inmates who could be released early. Good evening. I'm Paul Folch.
I'm Jessica Schambach. KOCO's Michael Seiden talked to the Attorney General to get some new answers about the investigation. Michael?
Yeah, we did sit down with the Attorney General. He told us he has not launched his own investigation, but Scott Pruitt did tell us that he is taking note of this 9-page letter written by Oklahoma County District Attorney David Prater.
What's offensive? It's offensive.
Attorney General Scott Pruitt isn't happy about this letter.
I'm not glad that I got the letter because that means you have people that have done things that are inconsistent with the law.
But
what I'm glad about is that light has been shed on a pardon and parole board that has acted inconsistent with the law. And we're going to do something about it.
The Attorney General's comments are in response to this 9-page letter. Inside, Oklahoma County District Attorney David Prater says the Pardon and Parole Board violated the Open Meeting Act and placed dozens of inmates on a secret docket. A docket that would allow convicted murderers and sex offenders to be released from prison before serving 85% of their sentences.
That those families that have been affected adversely are incensed, and they should be. And why should they be incensed? Because you've had someone substitute their judgment in place of a judge and a jury in violation of the law.
Families like Tim Sharp, he lost his father to a drunk driver. Tim alerted the district attorney after learning that Maylene Chambers could be released early from prison.
They can still call Maylene or write her letters or go visit Maylene, but I can't. My father's dead.
And we sat down when we were sitting with Attorney General Pruitt. We asked him, are these board members going to face charges? Will anybody face charges? And he just told us it's too early to tell right now. We'll continue to follow this story and bring you any new developments. Reporting live in Northwest Oklahoma City, Michael Seiden, KOCO, Eyewitness News 5.
Thank you, Michael. Now, the Pardon and Parole Board is responding. In a press release, they said, quote, to ensure the board process remains open and transparent, the chairperson will place a moratorium on the early consideration process. All board meetings are conducted according to the Oklahoma Open Meeting Act.